Like, I can't believe I was talking to this camera, you guys. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Yes, it is me, your girl, your favorite Freddy, back on your screens on yet another Wednesday. Before we get into this video, please don't forget to like, comment, share this video, and subscribe. But most importantly, please don't forget to hit that little bell in your bottom right corner so you can get notified every time I post a new video. Also, please do follow me on all my social media platforms at ismomandia. As you guys have seen in the title of this video, I'll be doing another chit-chat get ready with me. So this time I didn't go into my Instagram and put up a question for my followers to tell me what I should discuss. I decided to discuss something that I felt like discussing. So hopefully you guys enjoy the topic. So I will be talking to you guys about Love Island South Africa, and also, like, don't judge me just because I watched it so late, okay? Peer pressure is something I do not succumb to. So when I don't want to watch a show just after it has come out, I don't want to watch it, and I will watch it when I want to watch it. So yeah, better late than never, okay? So let's get started. Like, I can't believe I was talking to this camera and it wasn't recording. Anyway, child, so I had already started putting eyeshadow. So I'm using my Hermosa Flow Cosmetics eyeshadow palette, the White Lily palette. So I am mixing two colors because I don't want it to be too dark or too light, because I mean, these colors are quite, you know. So I'm mixing Majesty and Friendship. So as I was saying, that I would never be able to survive on Love Island because, one, like, I think I'm a person who catches feelings very quickly, so it would just be a pass for me. Like, it would be tough because, like, today you meet, okay, you get coupled up with someone sharp, you guys get to know each other, you guys get close and everything, and then tomorrow there's a new guy that comes in, or two new guys, and you feel like, oh, the new guys, oh, well, say that. Then the person now you are coupled with and you sleep with every single day, you guys, you are vibing, but you're also vibing with someone else, the other new guys that have come in. You kiss this one, now you like this one. Like, it's a mess. It is really a mess. So, like, it's really not for me. I don't want to lie to you guys. Thank God I'm in a relationship, because but okay, so I watched it. I watched it by myself. Am I watching? Yeah, I think I'm on episode 10 right now. So my favorite somewhat couple, I think let me say my top three favorites. Maybe, okay. I like, because after the, I think there's been two reshufflings already. So I like Timna and Libu? Yeah, Timna and Libu. I like Xavier and Millie. And who else? The others are just like friendship zones type of relationships. Like, they're not like, I think I liked Aaron and Assad first before their fallout, and that was so much drama. Like, I was like, you guys were together, man, Slavi Davi, and then Ufia Usera, and then all of a sudden Zimbinda, guys. You know. So my bottom three couples, no, like actually I think not bottom three, I don't have a bottom three because majority of them are like all coupled up with people that they feel safe around, like friendship vibes. So I don't like, I mean, some are occasionally they cute and stuff, but they are, I don't know, relationship is toxic because okay, Cage doesn't listen. I don't care who says what, like okay, just I'm mamele, and like Uputi was just listening to himself and his own thoughts, and I'm just like, bro, you're not listening to what Summer is saying. And then Magfiga Ukris, I swear, now you want to act right because there's another gent within the villa and you're feeling threatened because Osama likes talking to the gent. And I'm just like, you know, men never act right, and then they want to cry when you move on as a female. I'm just like you don't do the right things at the right times, but when you feel threatened, now you want to do the right things and say the right things and act right. And I'm just like, it doesn't work like that. So that's I'm at the episode where Kate had something to say to the people, and the two new girls came in. Okay, but anyway, so I think I'm done with my eyeshadow now. Very simple, very cute, very Sunday, because it is a Sunday today anyway. So now I think I'm gonna just, I made a mess and I want to fix it. Okay, so I think I'm gonna go and put on my lashes off camera because it's a mess, that one also. It's just like Live Island. I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. And I put on my lashes. So I saw this other trick on TikTok, right, whereby they say for your makeup to look bomb AF, and I've done this like twice already and I love it, is for you to put on your primer, which I've already done off camera, sorry. You put on your primer, then you put on your setting spray, then you put on your setting powder once your setting spray has dried off, and then only then do you put on your foundation, and that does wonders. I've tried it, guys, you must try it. It's really, it's a really great a tip. Oh, by the way, I'm using the Essence My Skin Perfecta loose powder. So yeah, as I was saying, I really don't like the way Ukage is so, I don't want to say possessive, but he seems like the type that is like, listen, if I don't have you, then no one will, type of thing. But like, not to that extent. Like, he's cute. The things that he does, like, I like. Once things done, he's really, yeah, yes, I want to say that. So, I'm gonna put on my foundation now. I use the Revlon Color Stay Full Cover Foundation, the one I recently did a review on my channel. If you haven't watched that video, please go and watch it. I'll link it somewhere up here. My shade is 410. So I was saying, Wooty Ukage, I dislike the fact that he spoke about him not wanting to compromise. Like, relationships are all about compromising, right? On certain things, yes, but not like every single thing. But like major things, like say for instance, I don't like being touchy feely all the time, and then right now you want to be touchy-feely all the time, and I'm just like, but you're not listening to me. I don't like that all the time. Yes, I like it, but like PDA, let's go for it, but maybe space also at the same time, you know. So he, I must look at you guys, sorry. So he seems like the type, I mean, he said it numerous times when he had conversations with Summer, Ubuti, and there's certain things he wouldn't compromise on, and I'm just like, Buti, Raibo, how do you expect to be in a relationship when you can't compromise on certain things, you know? So that was a big, like, but I think after, because Summer was in a pickle because she liked what's the other guy's name, Chris, yes, because she also liked Chris, and they told her Uguti, this thing of hers not being able to pick one guy is just not good, so she has to make a decision. And after she had told Kate Gucci, she's picking him, and they have like a lot of things that they had to work on. The only then did he like think about like changing his behavior, like, you know that thing when they say you only know what you have until it's gone. I think that's where he was when Osama had to make a decision, and he knew that if Osama didn't pick him, then, you know, because of who paid for him. But they chose him over Chris. Chris, he was giving me F-boy vibes, you know. At first that's what I thought about Ukage, but then I saw Uguti, he's really like, if he's the type of human who's like, if he's into someone, like, they into you only. And he was very, very loyal to Summer since the beginning of the show. So that's Summer and Cage. Those two, if they had to have a relationship out on the outside world, obviously I get to a point where I'll see Woody, where's who and who in life, like who got eliminated and stuff. But as for now, I just feel like, I don't know if Summer and Cage would have had a lasting relationship, like, outside the Love Island villa. So, but I really liked their vibe. The other couple that I really, really, really liked and I had hope for was Assad and Aaron. Oh, they were so cute. But the way it just went past so quickly, I was so shocked. Like, Jani, what told me? Like, how? Because they seemed like, if anyone was to stay in here, you know, I thought it would have been them. Can't you know? Usera Ofige Wati, Mrs. Steal Your Man. Oh, that's another thing that I could never be able to deal with. Like, just when we have Vumbuya, then you come and take the person that I was vibing with, like, and I'm invested already. No, that's another thing that I realized, that made me realize, you see, I would never be able to care on Love Island. No. It wouldn't work out for me. Okay, so now I'm gonna put on concealer. I use the Beauty Treat Precise Cover Concealer from this game. It's one of their makeup, in-store makeup brands. So yeah, like, the way it ended so abruptly. Also, like, yeah, it was shocking because I really had hope for Erin, and and Assad. Futhi Assad. Oh, guys, no. We were fanelana, like, not just because, like, I'm a colored, but they had something good going and they ruined it. Boba Bees. But I really like them. Too bad it didn't go nowhere because Aaron, like, I don't even know, like, what went wrong. Like, I watched it and I was just like, oh my gosh, but it didn't make sense. Let's see. Oh yes, I remember. Like, I remember because Aaron wanted a lot of things from Assad, and Assad was just like, that's not him. And Umugeli made him choose what it's either you do the things I want or like Gupeli Lingati. And I mean, sure, give an ultimatum, right? But not when you guys are still starting out, like, you can't. I feel. Yes, you as a person, you have things you want, right, in a relationship, and that's okay. But I feel like in the beginning you can't be throwing out I want you to do this or else it's over, you know, especially in a vicinity like that. Like, I mean, girl, what do you mean? Obviously uzohamba ubuthi, like, guys are quick to go. You should know that, you know. I thought, hey, like, me and our church, we all know those guys. Like, but Lord, heard that was a clean kiss here and move on, like, you were never there in front of your eyes with another woman. So, I mean, like, don't set yourself up for failure like that. I mean, what exactly are you expecting to happen, you know? So theirs was, it was cute while it lasted. Oh guys, so that was one thing. Let me get to the part of the things that annoyed me, right? I'm one person also, like, I am an emotional, well, I was, right? I don't just like, it's too many in your busy, I don't do that. So when I see someone crying, I'm going to contour with this LA girl, pro concealer. It's a very dark shade. I don't know what the shade is called. It is dark cocoa. So when, like, everyone was crying, I was just like, because he's not doing the thing that you want. Like, are you really going to show a man that you need him on live television? Says, please no. Like, I don't have sympathy for someone who's going to cry on TV, especially not on TV. But like, also, like, why are you crying? You must cry for real things. Like, no, to show me, like, you lost your job, like, you got a, like, you didn't get a bursary. Those things in water. Yee. Like, are you all? Guys, no, love yourselves, eh? Like, love yourselves. Need Tandy, please, say it. Is it Tandy? Please, for my sake. Like, no. If there's one thing, never cry for me. Yo, don't ever do that, bro. Cause I'm born is a wooty. That you need him when, in fact, like, I mean, yes, you do need him, right? But don't show him, because uzo dlalela lapho uzo ikhanda lakho. And then now they're gonna stick with you because really, so, you know. And I feel like I don't ever want to be in a situation like that where by a guy stays with you only because they feel I'm sorry for you. Like, don't waste my time. please move on. Like, go, it's fine. Like, it's okay. I'll be okay. I'll be fine by myself. Okay. That was one thing that annoyed me about Aaron, because like, okay, I'm girl. Like, why are you crying? So like, those are the certain things I look at that console. Anyway, I really liked the friendships that were formed. Like, the girls are super tight. I really liked it about the squads there. Like, the girls are really like girl code vibes. Like, you know, if something happens, they tell each other first, and whatever they hear from the gents, they talk about it, you know. So I felt like that was like, that's one thing I really, really liked about the friendships in terms of the girls there. The gents are tight, obviously. We all know how gents are when they're together, regardless of whether you guys know each other or not. Like, I think that's one thing I envy about gent friendships, is that normally they will like form new friendships so quickly. It's amazing. It's amazing. Love to see it, gents. What a contour, baby, sweetie. Okay, now that I've highlighted, contoured and concealed. Oh, it's so itchy. I'm going to now put on powder and with the essence powder again on the areas where I highlighted. Concealed. What's with me and the word highlight? But yeah, guys, it's like where I'm at. Like, it's interesting to watch. It's really, really, really interesting to watch the dramas unfold, you know, the conversations that people have, how they actually get to, you know, fall for each other and stuff. Yeah. So I'm excited to see how the first season ends. But I feel like they need to do better in terms of casting people. Like, there was like a a representation of black people on the show, but like, it wasn't as great as the other race. So I feel like they need to give more black people a chance. I know for sure that there were a lot more people who entered of my shade, not shade, but of my race, and they weren't given a chance. So I'm now going to go on my contoured areas with these Avon bronzing pearls. This is what it looks like inside. It isn't much. Is it true? Ah. So, I mean, I'm excited to see how these relationships, where they go. And if these people, like, I've already checked on some people's like IG, Instagram accounts, just to see what they are doing like now in life. Like, I checked, I think I checked Asad in Instagram. I checked who's. I can't remember whose other Instagram page I checked, but I checked quite a few just to see, you know, even though I'm not done with the show, but like I like to see where everyone else is in life, because you know, obviously the season is over. Well, everyone who's watched it knows who the winner is and stuff, so you know, I'm excited to see that. And yeah, like this highlight with this Essence Glow to Go highlighter palette, I really like this palette too. So I'm gonna use this shade here for highlighting, because it's the lightest for me. Can't even, like, I don't want it to make too much noise. I mean, you must see that I've highlighted, but don't fight the feeling, invite the feeling. What's up, guys? Please do let me know down in the comment section who your favorite couple was and why, and who was your least favorite person or couple, you know. I just want to know what your guys' thoughts were with regards to Love Island. I'm gonna go in with my Scarlet Hill setting spray now. While I let my setting spray dry, I'm going to now go down to the lips. I don't know, should I go red? No, don't feel like going red with him. So I'm gonna go with a nude lip. I'm just gonna outline my lips with this dark brown pencil. Then I'm just gonna go in with this nude matte lip gloss that I bought. Where did I buy it? It was channel. Look at these vibes, guys. So cute, because I haven't done my makeup in like 2 weeks specifically for YouTube, so messed on period. See you guys. Okay guys, this is the final look. I really hope you guys enjoyed my little chit chat, get ready with me and having this discussion about Love Island. I know my conversation was all over the place, but you know, I just hope you guys really enjoyed it. And please do let me know, guys, who your favorite couple was, if you have watched Love Island South Africa already. And if you haven't, I mean, if you want to watch it, go and watch it and see what it is that I'm talking about. But yeah, we've come to the end of the video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. Please let me know what you think about this makeup look. I think I'm just gonna make it my everyday makeup look as well, because it's really simple. And I mean, see what, guys, it's a summer, it's a hot girl summer, and you know the vibes, you know. So thank you guys so much for watching. See you guys in my next video. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. Bye.